Good morning, students. How are you all? I hope all are fine and studying at home safely. Okay. Today I am going to continue the lesson number five, chapter number five, the final word. Okay. In that concept connection. Okay. Grammar part concept connection. So now see subject verb agreement. So this is totally new for you. Just go through it. Subject means about what we are talking. Verb means agreement, means what we have done agreement with the verb, subject and verb. Just let us see. Subject verb agreement means that the verb must agree with the subject in person, first, second and third, and in number. This means both need to be either singular or both need to be plural. A singular subject should have a singular verb, whereas plural subject should have a plural verb. Okay, it means that whenever we are using the subject and verb with the subject, it should be agree with the subject, whether a first person, second person or third person in number. It means that hum logon ko singular subject ke sath singular verb use karna hai aur plural verb subject ke sath plural verb use karna hai. Again I am telling, singular subject ke sath singular सब्जेक्ट के साथ सिंगुलर वर्ब और प्लूरल सब्जेक्ट के साथ प्लूरल वर्ब. ओके, सो यू कैन सी दैट यू कैन से वन और मैनी, सिंगुलर और प्लूरल. सो सब्जेक्ट इफ इट इज सिंगुलर, वर्ब शुड बी सिंगुलर. इफ वर्ब इज सब्जेक्ट इज प्लूरल, वर्ब शुड बी प्लूरल. ओके, वन मैनी, यू डोंट नो, वन मैनी, सिंगुलर, प्लूरल, लाइक दैट. सो नाउ लेट अस सी द एग्जाम्पल. Now see, the mangoes in the basket are really delicious. Now see, mangoes, subject, the mangoes are subject here and mangoes are plural. Okay, in the basket are, they have used are here, not is. The mangoes in the basket is, no, is for singular, is there, so it is used are here, really delicious. So subject is also plural and verb is also plural here. Got my point? Now here mango is a subject, are is a verb, both are plural in number. Okay, like this. Now see, when we use the word in a simple present tense, we should be careful to use the form of the verb correctly. We know that a subject can be singular or plural. It can also be in the first person, second person or third person. Look at the table below to understand subject verb agreement in the simple present tense. So now we go to the tenses and let us see what happened in the tenses of singular and plural subject. Okay, first person, I sing, we sing. Okay, in both the first form of the verb is there with the plural, singular and plural both. In second person, you sing, no change. Singular also you, plural also you, and first form of the verb. Third person, he, she, it, or name of the person, any, okay, boy or girl. So he sings, she sings, it sings, or Meeta sings. Okay, so these are the singular subjects. Okay, with the first form of the verb plus s. Now they sing, plural is they, again here sing is there, no verb form is not changed. Okay, same it is in the plural subject. Okay, remember that it is only a third person singular that the verb takes s or es in the simple present tense. In the singular, only third person changes, remaining all are same verb. For example, I sing folk songs. I, first person singular. Meeta sings folk songs, third person singular. We play cricket after school, first person plural. She plays badminton after school, third person singular. Deepak goes to work at 8 o'clock every day, third person singular. A verb in a sentence must agree in person and number with its subject. A verb in a sentence must agree in person एंड नंबर विद इट्स सब्जेक्ट. अ सिंगुलर सब्जेक्ट टेक्स सिंगुलर वर्ब वाइल अ प्लूरल सब्जेक्ट टेक्स अ प्लूरल वर्ब. ओके सो लाइक दिस इज जस्ट सी for singular subject always take the singular verb and plural subject always takes plural verb. Here are some more examples. Some mangoes, the mangoes in this basket are really sweet. Now just now we have seen in the last page, subject is the mangoes and verb is are. Soumen plays the mouth organ beautifully. Subject is Soumen, verb is plays. Oil and water do not mix easily. Water subject, not mix is verb. Mix verb. The fox is a clever animal. Fox is subject, okay, is verb. Minnie loves to make dresses to her doll, for her dolls. Subject is Minnie, okay, loves is verb. So always with the singular subject always singular verb comes. Okay, everybody got my point? So always you have to write 10 examples of this subject verb agreement in the simple present tense. Okay, you have to write it and try to do this exercise with the pencil. Practice zone number 2, try to do with the pencil. Okay, now we already know that subject can be either singular or plural. Okay, we know that hum jiske bare mein baat karte hain wo singular bhi ho sakta hai, plural bhi ho sakta hai. Okay, so countable nouns, a pen, a box, the student, the cow, an ant, the elephant, countable nouns. Okay, uncountable nouns, furniture, sugar, hair, oil, coffee, coal, machinery. Plural subject, countable nouns, children, students, dog, cats. Children's is a wrong word, huh? Don't put S in front of that, because children itself plural. Child is singular, children is plural. Okay? Students, dogs, cats, babies, etc. Personal pronouns, I, you, he, she. Personal pronouns, I, you, he, she. Indefinite pronouns, each, either, neither, no one, nobody, anybody, somebody, something, nothing, everyone, everybody, everything. These are personal pronouns and indefinite pronouns. Indefinite pronouns, several, few, both, many in the plural. This is all in the singular and this all in the plural. Okay. Rules of subject verb agreement. Let us see the how to use when the subject has two or more singular nouns or pronouns joined by and. It requires a plural verb. Okay, जब दो या दो से ज़्यादा nouns होते हैं या pronouns, उसको and के साथ join किया जाता है. Okay, so it needs a plural verb. For example, platinum and gold are precious metals. Now see, platinum and gold, two things are there. So they are more than one. So it is plural. So R is used. Okay. Mother and father agree that playing games is the best way to exercise. Mother and father are the subject here. Okay. And agree, first form of the verb here, verb. Okay. So subject is mother and father and verb agreement is agree. Red apples and green apples have almost the same nutritional value. Red apples and green apples. Okay. These are the, this is the subject here, have is verb here, okay, helping verb. However, if the noun refers to the same person or thing, the verb is singular. यहाँ पे दो person use किए हैं, लेकिन यहाँ पर जो है वो verb singular ही है. Now see, for example, time and tide wait for none. Now time and tide, two things are there, okay, and wait is first form of the verb. The pride and honor of the award is all his. The pride and honor, both things are for the of the for the award. So it is singular, award is singular, so here is. The great queen and freedom fighter Rani Jhansi is. This is the adjectives, these are adjectives. Great queen and freedom fighter. Okay, so Rani Jhansi, it is a name of the subject. Okay, So Rani Jhansi, therefore she is singular here, so is will come is remembered for her exceptional courage. A ruler and compass is essential for a geometry class. Okay, a ruler and compass is essential because these two different things are there, they are used for the different purpose. So is used here. When two singular nouns or pronouns are joined by either or neither and nor, a singular verb is used. Either you are Akshat is mistaken about the dates of the exams. Okay, either you or Akshat, तुम या Akshat, दोनों में से किसी ने एक ने mistake किए dates exam के dates में. Neither of the hockey players was the goalkeeper of the team. Neither of the hockey players was the goalkeeper of the hockey team. Neither food nor water was available in the train as it was running late. Okay, na khana tha na pani tha, but not was helping verb, not available in the train as it was running late. When a singular noun or plural noun, noun and a plural noun or pronoun are joined by either or and neither nor, use a plural verb. For example, neither Samit nor his brothers resemble their mother. Either the aeroplane or the tanks were destroyed in the battle. So, क्या बोल रहा है कि ना ही सुमित और ना ही उसके brothers उसकी मम्मी जैसे दिखते हैं. Resembles verb. Okay? Neither Samit nor his brothers, they are subject. Either the aeroplane or the tanks. Either the aeroplane, या तो aeroplane या फिर tanks were destroyed in the battle. Battle में destroy होते हैं. With indefinite pronouns ending in one thing, body is singular verb is used. For example, everybody, somebody, okay? Everybody these days likes to keep in touch with their friends through the internet. Okay? So everybody these days likes to keep in touch with their friends through the internet. Someone has broken the beautiful flower vase. Okay, someone has broken. Now here singular, here also here third form of the verb. So in the indefinite pronouns ending in one thing or body is singular verb is used. Something is missing from his cupboard, like that. With indefinite pronouns, none, all, most, some and any use either a singular or plural verb depending on the meaning. Okay, so depends on the meaning also. Most of the students are going for the trip. Okay, most of the work is still to be completed. Students are there, so are is there. Most of the work, it is uncountable noun, so is there. None of the people have really seen the Yeti or the abominable snowman, but all are scared of it. Okay, so none of the people means there are plural here, therefore have is there. Nouns modified by each or every use a singular verb even when and is used to join the nouns. For example, each of the actors was given an award for their excellent performance. Now you are thinking that each of the actors written here. तुम सोच रहे होंगे यहाँ पे actor है या plural है, तो was क्यों है यहाँ पर, were होना चाहिए. Yes, but each of the actors बोला है, हर actor में से हर एक actor. Got my point? Each of the actors मतलब बहुत सारे actors में से एक actor. Each of the actors was given an award. सबको award दिया गया, हर एक actor को award दिया गया. Every boy and girl in the class has been given a role in the play. Every boy and girl in the class has given a role in the play. Every boy and girl means one boy, one girl. Every one boy, every one girl. All the boys and girls. So a singular. It is a singular term. So it has been written here. Given a role in the play. So every boy and girl. So many are there, but it is used here. Every face showing to each. Okay. Now when two subjects of different persons are joined by either or nor, either or, then the verb must agree with the nearer subject. Either he or I am going to attend the function. अभी तो he am तो लिखेंगे नहीं, है ना? I के साथ हमेशा am जुड़ता है, ओके प्रेजेंट टेंस में, तो आइदर ही ये लिख दिया हमने, या तो वो या फिर मैं फंक्शन अटेंड करने के लिए जा रहा हूँ। जो बाद में जो प्रोनाउन होता है उसके हिसाब से सेंटेंस पूरा किया जाता है। आइदर ही और आई एम गोइंग टू, ही एम नहीं आएगा, आई एम गोइंग टू अटेंड द फंक्शन। नाइदर यू नॉर दे आर टू बी ब्लेम फॉर हिज सडन चेंज ऑफ प्लान्स, ना तो तुम या फिर वो, ठीक है, तो नाइदर यू और नॉर दे आर टू बी ब्लेम, सडन चेंजेस को ब्लेम नहीं कर सकते। क्वांटिफाइज लाइक सेवरल, फ्यू, बोथ, मैनी, टेक प्लूरल वर्ब्स, ओके। सो फॉर एग्जाम्पल सेवरल चिल्ड्रन क्वांटिफाइज मतलब जो क्वांटिटी बताते हैं, ओके, क्वांटिटी बताते हैं उनको क्वांटिफाइज बोलते हैं। सेवरल बहुत ज़्यादा मतलब काउंटिंग नहीं है, फ्यू मतलब थोड़ा, बोथ मतलब दोनों, मैनी मतलब बहुत ज़्यादा, ओके, तो दीज आर ऑल प्लूरल क्वांटिफाइज। सेवरल चिल्ड्रन पार्टिसिपेट इन द मैराथन एवरी ईयर, कुछ बच्चे हर साल मैराथन में पार्टिसिपेट करते हैं। अ फ्यू मोर पेंसिल्स आर नीडेड इन द आर्ट रूम, आर्ट रूम में थोड़ी और पेंसिल्स ज़्यादा चाहिए। बोथ द सिस्टर्स आर प्लानिंग टू जॉइन क्लासेस, ओके, बोथ द सिस्टर दोनों बहनें जो हैं वो हॉबी क्लासेस ज्वाइन करने का सोच रहे थे। इट वॉज द थिंकिंग ऑफ फादर, सो बोथ द सिस्टर्स आर, बिकॉज बोथ द सिस्टर्स वी आर टेलिंग दोनों बहनें, तो उसमें दोनों चीज़ें प्लूरल आ गए, तो दोनों बहनें आर, बोथ द सिस्टर्स आर प्लानिंग टू जॉइन हॉबी क्लासेस, ओके। सो लाइक दिस वर्ब एग्रीमेंट, सब्जेक्ट वर्ब एग्रीमेंट इज ओवर हियर, एंड आई विल सेंड द पिक्चर्स, एंड बाय द टाइम यू ट्राई टू डू विद द पेंसिल, लेट अस सी यू कैन डू और नॉट, जस्ट यू ट्राई टू डू विद द पेंसिल और एक्सरसाइज इज गिवन हियर, ओके, डू विद द शॉर्ट पेंसिल, ओके, दिस वन एंड दिस वन, सो आई विल सेंड द आंसर्स आफ्टरवर्ड्स, ओके। आई थिंक यू ऑल हैव अंडरस्टूड, ओके, थैंक यू, बाय बाय।